Hey folks, how's it going? It's Matt with On Trail Training. First off, I want to start with a little bit of an announcement. Due to, well, everything that's going on, I'll be pushing the beginning of the season back till probably at least May. We'll know a little more in the coming weeks here. But I know I already have a lot of you registered for classes in April. Don't worry, I'll be reaching out to you by email. See what you want to do. If you want to get into a later class, take a refund. We will take care of you on it. Don't worry about it. But I figured, while we're all sitting at home, might as well use this time to put together a little video series, and I'm going to call this Tailgate Talks, because, well, we're standing at the tailgate of my truck right now. And I had a customer this morning reach out and wanted a little bit of a refresher on splicing synthetic winch line. So I said, hey, great opportunity to do that. Fairly easy process. We can do this out on trail with a real minimum of tools. All I really need is a FID. This is a fancy one. This is the fast FID from Factor 55. If I don't have one of these, I can improvise it with a pen while I'm out on trail. I'm running through the process. It's a couple quick, easy steps. A lot of people get really intimidated by this, but this is a permanent fix to it. This is not just a temporary get me home fix like we talk about in some of our other videos. First thing I'll want to do, we're gonna wind up in a couple minutes doing a deep berry splice where I take this end of the line and feed it back down inside of itself. As we do that, it creates a line that's fairly thicker through the splice, and right at the end of it, I get this little quick sharp drop off that creates a pretty significant reduction in line strength. So I wanna taper this line down to cut it from about a 20% reduction in line strength down to about a 3%. I can handle the 3%. We'll start that taper process. I take a little bit of masking tape and put it on the end, helps keep the end together, keeps it a little neater as we go with this. And the masking tape isn't that hard to pull apart, so it'll be a little easier to work with. I'll start back about a foot from my cut end, and I pick a strand, and I pull that strand all the way out of the line. Till I get that strand all the way separated from it. And then I'll take a razor blade. I use razor blades with this because they're fairly disposable. Don't use your pocket knife for this. This really tends to eat through blades. This will dull this razor blade from a brand new blade. After about three of these cuts, it'll be time to change that blade out. But I'll take that strand, fold it over there, put a little bit of tension on it, and cut right down through it. I'll continue doing that all the way up. I'll pull one strand. I go up about an inch, I pull another strand out and I cut it, another inch, pull it out, cut it. So I go from a 12, 11, 10 strand thick line all the way down to one or two strands on the end. Gives me this nice even taper as I go down. Next thing I'll want to do once I get that whole taper down, it'll look something kind of like this. This has been spliced several times, so it's a little fuzzier than normal. I'll take my FID. And I'll use this to measure out my minimum distance. FIDs are size. Let me use the old one here. FIDs are size, not just diameter of the line, but they're also a measuring tool. For that deep berry to be effective, I need to go at least two FID lengths into the rope. That's the minimum. The farther past that I go, makes the line just a little bit stronger as I go. The Factor 55 one has them laser etched on the side. On here, for the 7/16 inch line we're using, minimum berry is 22 to 32 inches. I'm gonna go just a little bit past that, out to about 3 feet. I'll take, as I do that, and place a thimble in there. This thimble serves a couple purposes. One, the line's gonna wrap around the outside of it here. It's gonna protect that line from my connection points. So any nicks or burrs on any of my bow shackles won't affect my line. It also maintains a minimum bend radius. Depending on which standard you go by, the minimum is about 1.5 to 2 times. Industrial standards, a lot of times 3 times the diameter of the line. I don't want the line making a tighter turn than that. It starts weakening the line. So as long as we stay north of that 1.5 or so, we're pretty good. I will take the line, and I'm going to use the fast fit here because it's a little easier. Kind of fold that taper over in half. If you kind of put these on your hip, I don't have a third hand. And I can shove that tapered bit down inside the basket and extend that basket, straighten it out over it there. These work kind of like the old Chinese finger traps we had when we were kids. The tighter you pull on it, the more it squeezes around. Same principle that deep berry splice is going to work under. Because that relies on that outer line squeezing the inner line to keep it in place, It needs a certain amount of tension on there to actually do its job. So the first bit of every pull, when that line's just beginning to tension, I can get a little bit of movement, a little bit of creep in there. Might move the line a millimeter or two until that outer line tightens out enough. So I'm going to do a couple locking passes on there. I could just do the deep bury. I could stitch it with some heavy, like I use a wax-coated thread for it. Or I could do something fancy like a locking Bremel splice. They're literally books that thick on different splices you can do. We're going very simple, very easy to remember on this one. I'm going to start by measuring off. I go back to about where the end of my taper is. I'm about 6'2". So if I hold a hand in the middle of my chest, stretch my arm out, that gives me about 3 feet of bury right there. I'll pull a couple more inches to make up some room for the thimble. I place the thimble in there. And my first pass is going to be to take this FID and put the line straight through itself at 90 degrees. I want to go fairly in the middle. I want 6 strands on each side, and I don't want to separate the strands with this thimble, or with this FID, sorry. I'll get it in and pull it down to where it's fairly snug on there. That's my first pass. Now I'll flip the rope over 180 from there. Come back in the other side, coming back straight into it, about an inch down or so. Same thing in the middle of the line, and I don't want to separate those strands as I do it. We got those two. That will help keep the line in place under that first little bit of pull, so my line, so my loop doesn't get a little bigger at the end. Now I'll start my deep bury with it. Again, I go down about an inch. And now I'm going to take the FID and I'm going to feed it down the center of the rope. And we will keep feeding this. I just kind of feed that working end up, get some slack built up on it, and then I just slide it right up over the basket and over the table. And I'll keep burying and keep burying. This is the exciting part of the video, I know. Sometimes as I'm working with it, the FID might pop out, no big deal. All I do is back up a little bit, take some slack, get that FID back in the line, and keep at it. Almost down to the end. Once I get down to the end, you can measure this out and do some little marks with some Sharpie on there if you like. Just kind of run through this quick. I get down to the end and I poke the FID out. I will definitely want to remove this because this will not feed onto your winch drum. I promise you that. That will once, but that's it. Now I'm just going to remove the basket, take my taper at the end, and straighten that out a little bit so everything's nice and neat as we go in there. Get a little tug, just tighten that up. And now I've got all that slack build up. Here's my kind of spliced end with the tail. And all I do is I take that slack and I'm just squeezing the rope and sliding it down as I go. Get down to the end. That end buries in there nice and neatly. And now I've got a permanent end on that winch extension line. This could be on my main rope coming off of the drum. I could use this for an extension, very quick, very easy. Don't be intimidated by this. This is a pretty simple one. If you folks have any other ideas for videos you'd like to see me do, please let me know. I'd be happy to put a couple minute video together on all sorts of topics. Comment in the comment section, shoot me a message, email, and we'll see you out on the trail someday soon here. Thanks folks, talk to you soon.